चैप्टर 10 क्लास 4 टॉपिक द फिशरमैन फिशरमैन ग्रीडी वाइफ ग्रीडी वाइफ इट इज अ स्टोरी अबाउट अ ग्रीडी वाइफ टू द फिशरमैन हियर इज अ स्टोरी समरी लॉन्ग लॉन्ग अगो इन द डेज ऑफ विचेस एंड फेरीज विचेस एंड फेरी नो दैट अबाउट देम स्पेल एंड विशेस बीइंग ग्रांटेड There lived a poor farmer with his wife in a small but close to the sea. The fisherman worked hard at sea all day long, but generally never caught any fish. They spent their all in poverty. They spent their all life in poverty. So let's start their next summary. Rest summary. One day the fisherman felt a tot at his net and pulled it into his boat. He was overjoyed at the sight of a very large fish as he took the fish out of the net. The fish spoke, "Please don't kill me. I am an enhanced prince. I can help you with whatever you want." Means the fish spoke to the fisherman, please don't kill me, I am enhanced prince, I can help you with whatever you want. The fisherman let the fish go into the sea and went home empty handed as usual. His wife yelled at him, means his wife scolded to him, why do you come in empty hand? And could not stop her flow of angry words till they told her about the fish. She again yelled at him saying, "You foolish man, knowing our poor condition, you should have asked the fish for help. Now go back to the same spot and say to the fish, change our teeny house into a fine cottage." So the next day he went back to the sea and called out to the fish. The fish appeared. Almost at once the fish said, "Go back home and you will find your wife sitting in a cottage." And it was as the fish said, they also had fat laying hen and a shed full of grain, but his wife was not satisfied because his wife was not satisfied because he was already greedy woman. So she continued her aim. She kept behind him to go back to the fish to give them a cottage, a castle. Week went by and even though the fisherman was quite content with the cottage, his wife wanted more and more. His desire became more and more. So he went back to the fish and the fish granted them a castle. The greedy wife now started forcing the fisherman to go back and ask the fish for the palace and to make her the queen. He went again to the fish with his wife's request and the fish said, "So be it. So be it." The fisherman went back to see a palace in place of castle with sentries guarding the gate and his wife on the throne with a crown on her head. The greedy foolish woman stood up when the fisherman said to her, "Are you content now?" She yelled, "No, I want to be the empress." The fisherman did not want to ask the fish for any more favors because he felt sent to her wife his desire more and more. But his wife threatened to have his head cut off, so he went back to the fish. The fish once again did what he asked and she became the empress. The fisherman, on seeing his wife, now the empress, said, "You must be quiet, content now that you are the empress to which she fly. I am the empress, no doubt, but I still cannot control the wind and the waves. Go tell the fish to make me equal to God. Wow. The fisherman trembled at his wife's words because he wanted to make the God. He went to the sea hastily and whispered his wife's wishes to the fish. So student, here is the last paragraph of the greedy wife of the fisherman. One on hearing his words, a fierce storm arose and the fish said, "Go home and you will find your wife sitting in old pig's tail." The greedy woman got what she deserved. So student, learn this lesson. We don't be greedy to anything. So satisfy what you have, anything. So thank you.